Man, we're hitting a picture on the TV.
I'm Michael Bosick. Welcome to this week's edition of Sierra Shorts, the show that rides up on you.
Not to think too often.
It's probably a safe thing. It's kind of Buddhist, huh?
Yeah. You know, it gives me a headache.
My psychiatrist is really depressed.
Sierra Shorts.
Hi, it's me, Chela, and I'm doing the Consumer Reports on the mini vacation. I'm in this little town called Farad. It's just east of the Nevada border here on Highway 80, and I think it's called Farad or Farad. I'm not sure, but some Arabs, they used to live here from what I understand, and they got buried in the snow or something. I don't know. They're not here no more. In fact, right behind me is a sign here that's closed. You really can't get into the town, and it's so old it's faded, and it says warning, private property, no trespassing. So you can't really come here, but just in case they want to open it again, I think you should really check it out. Anyway, it's me, Chela, and my dog Ginger saying see you later. Bon voyage.
All right. Excuse me, can we talk to you?
Yeah,
it appears you have two fish on your shoulders. Now, what kind of fish are those?
Blackmore goldfish. I just finished doing my dad, now I'm gonna do my mom.
That's a nice shirt you have there.
Thanks a lot, man. My wife made this for me. This is my lucky Reno convention shirt.
Valuable prize from Sierra Shorts, a classic Paisley Brain Cell CD or cassette. Click on our website, www.sierrashorts.com, on the World Wide Web. That's www.sierrashorts.com, the site that rides up on you.
Ready? We're ready. What? James Wilkinson, 34, told Los Angeles police that he attached a 15-foot wooden cross to the Y of the Hollywood sign, decorated it with plastic Christmas wreaths, a U.S. flag, empty beer cans and cigarette boxes, and then climbed onto the cross and strapped himself to it because art speaks for itself, quote unquote. Wilkinson, a musician who performs under the name Jizzo Pearl, was charged with trespassing. Lieutenant Charles Roper of the Los Angeles Police Department explained, everybody's trying to get their 15 minutes, quote unquote.
The picture comes shorter.
Jared Revis for Sierra Shorts here with a holiday safety moment. Tonight's topic will be about condom safety. Now, the most commonly asked question about condoms are they sturdy enough and are they large enough for me? And hopefully this little demonstration that we are going to do this evening will answer those questions adequately for you. Now, don't try this at home. My assistants and I are both highly trained professionals, and this is highly dangerous. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ben Barrett Revis for Sierra Shorts.
Wait! My Oscar Mayer Wiener whistle! Here comes little Oscar now!
Greetings, Martians! I bring gifts! Oscar Mayer cold cut! Help yourself! I've got over 20 different kinds.
All your favorites, like all we... Hi, everybody, and thanking you for joining us. My name's Shorty Sexpert, and this is Famous Man of the 20th Century. Today in the studio, we have, you guessed it, Little Oscar. Little Oscar is famous for driving the big Wienermobile around the United States during the 40s, 50s, and 60s. Little Oscar, thanks for joining us on the show.
Glad to be here.
What was the weirdest thing you ever saw go into a weenie?
A pair of false teeth.
A pair of false teeth.
Yeah, they went into the machine. They're all ground up into pulp, and
I guess that weenie could eat itself.
Just about.
What the heck is that?
Everybody,
Jesus!
Freeze, weenie boy! Everybody, freeze! Chip Tracy, private detective.
Hey, this is my show.
I'm gonna tell you something, Shorty. We got a deadbeat dad. I've tracked him from the Vegas Hills to Des Moines, from Dubuque to Niagara. He can't cut the mustard.
You've tracked nobody. You're going to hear more about this. I'm going to see my lawyer tomorrow.
Right. All right, I'll tell you what, Mr. Weenie Man. I've got the notes right here.
How could you do this, little Oscar?
1956, I see you haven't been paying your child support. I'll tell you what, I'd like to take you across the face with five fingers myself.
I look down to you.
Hey, I've been sending her a check every month. $50 a month. What's she been doing with that money?
Weenie boy, I call him as I see him. You're going in, you're going down the river. How does it feel to have your wings pulled off,
I'm
huh?
I'm going with
Come
you.
Come on, you're going in. You're going down the river.
Hey, this is my interview. This is my interview, I'm telling you. This is my interview.
All right.
Christ.
All right, it's all over for you, buddy. That's it.
This is little... No, I'm not little. This is Shorty Sex, but talking to you from men of the 20th century? What the hell am I doing here?
I think maybe that the best thing for you to do is fire up that barbecue and get out there and roast some weenies. What do you think?
Didn't have time to eat today. Instead, indulged myself in a glass of wine, which went directly to my brain. The last swallow made me long to crawl into the plastic cup, to be compressed and contained, become weighty and saved for later, all lukewarm and flat. I want to be stirred.
Washington Post's Style Invitational asks readers to take any word from the dictionary, alter by adding, subtracting, or changing one letter, and supply a new definition. Here's some entries. Hepatitis, terminal coolness. Osteoporosis, a degenerate disease. Carmageddon, it's like when everybody's sending off all these really bad vibes, right? And then like the earth explodes and it's like really a serious bummer. Glibido, all talk and no action. Doppler effect. The tendency of stupid ideas to seem smarter when they come at you rapidly. Ignoranus, a person who's both stupid and an asshole. A man, age 43, was arrested when he happened to attempt a bank robbery at the same time the police officer was in the lobby briefing employees on what to do in case of a bank robbery.
So are you going to brew some cider then?
Yeah, I'm going to brew my own cider.
Yes.
Sweet cider.
Yes.
Like sweet cider. I'm gonna get pissed on my head. No, no, here's my head. We're going to be on the telly.
No, you won't see it here.
When will we see it?
You won't see it here.
Oh, right.
No, it won't be in England.
Oh, where will it be?
In Reno, Nevada.
Where's that?
In the USA.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, hi, I'm Ireland, from Ireland.
Hi, watch Sierra Shorts on the web at www.sierrashorts.com. Do it now.
Okay, go ahead.
Welcome to the What Can I Say News. I'm Elrod Flubbert. In Wheeling, West Virginia, a man has proven yet again that crime and stupidity don't mix. After stealing a rifle from a house and bullets from a supermarket, Ben Lee Moore headed over to the Fritz the Cat adult sex toy shop for the holdup. Unfortunately for Mr. Moore, he neglected to check that the ammunition was not correct for the gun. His caper was foiled when he tried to shoot the store assistant after allegedly demanding money. According to Sergeant David McLaughlin of the Ohio County Sheriff's Office, this guy has to go down as one of the idiots of the year. What can I say?
It happens every night. It's not just an isolated incident. Maybe it's someone you know. All across this great nation, millions of seemingly ordinary people will begin the arduous task of fixing some form of flesh for dinner tonight. Perhaps it's at your house. Flesh, it's what's cooking.
English stud actor Hugh Grant is not too thrilled about his new hairdo. According to the Star, his spiky new coif makes him look like a lesbian. The 40-year-old actor had his trademark foppish locks lopped off earlier this year in favor of the fashionable crop, of which he says, "It's all too short and spiky, and I look like Mrs. Tigglywinkle in the Beatrix Potter books." He also admitted to the May edition of Talk magazine, "I went and tried to have this trendy haircut, and now I look like a lesbian on the female tennis circuit." What can I say?
Do you want to make more money? Sure, we all do.
You can start an exciting career now by learning a trade through Career College in Northern Sun Valley today. Get your certificate in laundry attendant, bus person, sanitary technician, janitorial services, change person, bathroom attendant, convenience store cashier, bouncer, auto mechanic, pizza delivery, landfill supervisor, narcotics distribution, taxi driver, fast food service, dishwasher, or get your degree in prostitution, trailer technician, meth lab assistant, amphetamine distribution. So make that call.
Hi, Patty. It's me. Did you get your check today? Great. Well, I'll meet you at the laundromat after I change my clothes. Bye.
Come on.
Hi, Benita.
Hey.
It's about time you put this guy here. You got my money?
Yes. Whoa, look at that Benita. Isn't she due soon? What'll that be? 7 she popped out?
Yes, 7 brats. Boy, I wish I had her welfare check.
I met you, you were on 4th Street selling your butt. You ungrateful little tramp.
And from our Canadian news desk, an Oshawa, Ontario woman decided that her neighbors were getting just a little too nosy, and took action in her own style. After Michelle Rathman and David Mock installed video surveillance cameras and a public address system to broadcast insults at her, Anne Rudka responded by hurling dead birds, eggs, and grease in their garden. Ugh. All three ended up in Ontario Superior Court, and the judge ordered them to pay compensation to each other. Apparently, the neighbors got along fine until Mr. Mark moved in with Ms. Rathman. What can I say, eh?
The early bird gets the worm, but it's the second mouse who gets the cheese. Don't sweat the petty things, and don't pet the sweaty things. It's not the pace of life that concerns me, it's a sudden stop at the end.
What did the Mexican say to the house?
I don't know.
Get off me, Holmes.
Reno is a joke.
Big time.
Just for me, you know.
We've got Shelley Preston here, and she can tell us what this wall is.
This wall is made by Entreprise. It's a company out of Bend, Oregon. It's a fiberglass artificial climbing wall that can be put up in your home or in a climbing gym. You'll see that there are holds, that all the things you were grabbing as you went up and standing on and thrutching about on, can be bolted onto either a surface like this, which is an artificial sand resin fiberglass panel, or even onto a plywood wall, and you could do it in your own garage. So you too could have a wall like this at home to climb on every day.
Cool, so you don't need the wall specifically, but you need the knobs, right?
You can do it either way. A lot of indoor climbing gyms use panels like this. It's a more expensive alternative. A less expensive alternative, if you want to do it in your own home, would be to use plywood panels, and you could talk to the people at Entreprise in Bend, Oregon, and just bolt on these holds. We call them plastic. We refer to this as climbing on plastic.
Is it plastic? That's what it's made
of? Not exactly plastic, but it's a combination of sand and resin and fiberglass.
Wow.
Man in Germany who had a blood alcohol level that was four times over the limit and had no driver's license was so angry after being told that he could not buy gasoline because his money was fake that he drove to a police station to complain where he was promptly arrested. Next time you are driving behind an 18-wheeler, consider this. According to a Pennzoil survey that appeared in Truckers News, 46% of women who responded admitted applying makeup while behind the wheel, as did 4% of the men. More than 9% plucked nose hairs while jammed in traffic.
I have a question for you about your tattoo. Are those Japanese or Chinese characters?
It's Japanese, kanji. Japanese.
Kanji?
Yeah.
And what does it say?
It's my mom's name, and then it says mother underneath it.
Right. Are there a lot of people with tattoos in Salt Lake City?
Yeah. Yeah.
How many people in the Mormon Tabernacle Choir have tattoos?
None.
What does it feel like to be an Italian?
Wouldn't you like to know?
You feel more Italian after having spent the day down here?
Well, a little bit. If I drink a little wine, yeah.
So what is your favorite thing about Italy? The wine?
The pretty women.
All right. How does it feel to be an Italian?
Italian?
You aren't Italian, are you?
No, I'm not Italian.
Okay. What's your favorite thing about Italy?
In Italy?
Yes, uh-huh. The food, the women, the cars?
The food.
Italian all the way.
Are you an Italian?
Oh yeah.
What does it feel like to be an Italian?
Like shit. No, just kidding.
Yeah, good sense of humor, the Italians always. What's your favorite thing about Italy? If you had it narrow.
The women, yeah, oh yeah.
Second?
The men, no.
Favorite thing about Italy is?
The tits and the women.
Are you a real Italian?
No, I'm half.
You're a half Italian. Now what does it feel like to be half Italian?
I don't know.
Are either one of you Italian?
No.
Molto bene, melted di galline. This old chicken shit for you.
What's your favorite thing about Italy?
Women.
How about you?
I don't know.
Awaiting a bubbly fate. I don't recall what the offending words were, but a bubbly fate awaited after speaking them out loud to my mother. It was a cleansing of sorts, a lingering, scented lesson of life. I do remember, though, from that time forward, toothpaste became a delicacy.
I have a television, so I probably won't listen to any radio, really.
We're wasting tape.
Check this out. To begin with, of course, an anachronism is anything which is out of its time. Such as, of course, say a flintlock rifle in the 20th century. What we do as a society is recreate the fun aspects of the Middle Ages and Renaissance periods of all over the world. We're family-oriented, non-profit, educational, and international in scope. What we like to do is to recreate tournaments, banquets, grand balls, anything that they did to have fun, not just to escape the 20th century, but to add those things that have passed by that we thought were so worthwhile recreating of. It's a fun organization. The armor that you're looking at here is German Gothic 1540 style, my own particular type that I favor. Many of the different armors that have been seen, probably on this own caption tape, are anything from chainmail to boiled leather and wax. Within the society, we like to be able to recreate any period from 600 to 1600 from any culture in the world.
How would one from Northern Nevada get involved in your organization?
Well, to begin with, of course, there are two very prominent chapters, one centered here in Reno that we call the Shire of the Silver Deserts, and also one towards the Minden and Gardnerville area.
Has this improved your sex life?
Actually, I'm not certain if it's improved it as much, but a lot of lassies find it's a wonderful thing for a good man to be so available. Yeah, so stay out of my
way, baby. We're wasting tape.
Earth Day at Idlewild Park in sunny downtown Reno. Let's go check it out. Let's talk to this guy right behind me. Hey, how's Earth Day? Is it fun? Are you having a good time? And do you recycle or do you drive an SUV? Well, our first respondent here, as you can see, is not very talkative. So let's go see if we can find some other people. We're here with Krista Taylor, KTHX, Radio X. And there's been a lot of reports of Radio X actually being a robot or satellite station, pre-recorded and canned. But as you can see, here is a real disc jockey.
I am a real person. There are real people at the X, KTHX, FM 100.1. No, seriously, there are real people at the X.
You see the system over there?
Right.
All that's the battery, I guess. You have to load the battery, and when the battery is loaded, the engine, the gasoline engine, load the battery, and when the battery is loaded, it's the engine stop and that battery started the car. I think that's the way it works, but I'm not an engineer, you know.
Is that an organic camera?
Organic.
So what?
No, the person holding it is.
What are you doing out here at Earth Day?
I came from Pyramid to see the.
Salve la Terra. Salvare la Tierra. Sauve la Terra. Save the Earth.
Is the stress of everyday life getting you down? Relieve that stress with Comadose. New from Chem 2000, Remedies of the Future, available over-the-counter today. Each dose is pre-measured for your convenience. Just three little pills and you're minutes away from total stress relief. Comadose relieves you of those troublesome higher brain functions that cause stress, inducing a calm, relaxed state not unlike a light coma. Remember, it's Comadose for the most relaxing, stress-free night you have ever had.
Tara shorts is just like one of those things. It's like being brushed. You know, it makes you feel really good.
Thank you for joining us here at Sierra shorts.